Good morning. Well, mothers and fathers were bringing their children to Jesus that Jesus might bless them. Jesus said to his disciples, "Let the children come unto me. Do not hinder them, but to such things belong the realm of God. Truly, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God like a child shall not enter into it." So this morning, we are going to invite Cyrus and his family to come forward for his baptism. Oh, if he wants to.
The sacrament of baptism demonstrates that God's love and grace is freely given to Cyrus, but also to all of us. We baptize with water and the Holy Spirit to mark his acceptance into the care of the church. It is a symbol of God's forgiveness and love for us. It is the beginning of his journey of faith.
And so I'm going to ask you a couple of questions. The first, Destiny, do you desire to have Cyrus baptized into the faith and family of Jesus Christ? If so, please say, "I do." Do you promise, this is family, do you promise to encourage Cyrus in the ways of love and peace which lead to a new life? If so, please say, "We will with the help of God."
We will with the help of God.
And will you teach him that he may be led to live a life of love? If so, please answer, "We will with the help of God."
We will with the help of God.
And do you promise by the grace of God to treat all people with dignity and respect? Again, if so, please answer, "We do with the help of God."
We will with the help of God.
Do you promise to grow with Cyrus in faith, to help him in matters of faith and nurture him in the church, that he may affirm this baptism and know that God loves him?
We do.
We do.
Light has long been a symbol for God, for God's love and God's Spirit. Jesus was described as the light of the world, and each of us was said to have that same light within us. This afternoon, this morning, we are presenting to Destiny a baptismal candle. In times of difficulty or worry, you can relight this candle, reminding you that God's blessing and light still remains upon and within Cyrus.
Do you promise to support Cyrus in faith, to hold him in the light and spirit of God when he cannot hold it for himself? If so, please answer, "We will, with God's help." Cyrus, are you okay, maybe? I'm sorry, you had a bad day. All right. Let us pray. Gracious God and most holy, bless this water, lay your spirit in it, create a new life in the one baptized in it this day. And may Cyrus know the peace and love of God, who was and is and shall ever be. Amen. So Cyrus, we're going to put our finger in the water and then touch your head, okay? Is that okay with you? You want to do it with me? Okay, we'll just pretend. We'll do a pretend. Okay. Don't worry, Cyrus. It's okay. Watch this. All right.
Cyrus, I baptize you in the name of God, whom Jesus called Father.
And in the name of Jesus Christ.
And of the Holy Spirit. Cyrus, child of God, may the Holy Spirit be upon you now, forever guiding you, protecting you, inspiring you. May the love, the joy be abundant in your life this day and forevermore. Now there is a congregational response, which is in your bulletin, a promise that we make to Cyrus. Let us please read that together.
It is our pleasure to welcome Cyrus into the heart as members of our family, the family of Christ. We pledge ourselves to be sisters, brothers, aunts, and uncles in Christ in heaven. We pledge as best as we are able to surround him with God's kind of love, total and unconditional. We accept our sacred responsibility to help him grow together with us all to full humanity as we see it in Jesus. So we have a tradition in our community, you all got bubbles. And so one of the beauty of bubbles is that they're all beautiful, they're all unique, they're all different, just like Cyrus. And so we're gonna introduce Cyrus to the community if he's up for it and walk him around. And at the same time, I invite you all to sing Jesus Loves Me and blow bubbles for Cyrus. Thank you.